Hello and welcome back to another small Mercedes video. In this week I had two of these W123 estate in my garage. Both of them needed a new exhaust system, at least the rear of it, and they have been changed on both of them. The green one and the white one. The white one is no longer here, but the green one is still. I've changed the exhaust. Another issue with this one is a coolant leak, which means that you have to top it up every once in a while. And that's the big issue about that is if you forget it, the car overheat, for one thing. The other thing is that you tend to begin to add water instead of coolant. When a car leaks coolant, that wouldn't be a problem unless you had winter with freezing temperatures, and we do have that in Denmark. So and the winter is coming up, so it's a good thing to check the coolant freezing point and add some coolant if needed. But this video will be all about finding the leak. I do not have a coolant pressure tester, because if you had that, it would be very easy. But I'm gonna do it another way. You could also just have the car running up to temp, because the pressure in the coolant system should show the leak just by pressure from the running engine. But I find it to be much more nice to do it without the engine running. One thing is the noise, another thing is the smell, which is dangerous, of course, inside. Unlike the white car from the previous video, this is not a diesel. This is a petrol version, which is a bit rare, I think. Other than that, it's also a manual, which is even rare. It's not that it's extremely rare, but normally these are diesel and automatic, at least in Denmark. Other than that, it's pretty much the same setup with the hydraulic system and all that. Normally, you would get a pressure test kit for doing this, and that actually is pretty simple. It would be a lid like this that was sealing up here, and then had a nozzle right here where you could pump in pressure to pressurize the system. I do not have that. I'm gonna try to do it another way. This is the overflow hose. This will pump out excessive coolant if the system is at high pressure. But we're going to use it to try to do this pressure test. What we're going to do is to take the vacuum gauge I have. You could use compressed air from the compressor, but do not put too much pressure into it. Like this. And then I'm gonna just hold my hand over here and pump it up. And then you can actually sometimes hear the leak, and I can in this instance, and I can also see the leak already. Let me see if I can get some light. Let's put on some light, and I think you can see it down there. Yeah. So we found the leak already. And of course you could have other leaks in the system, but I do not think so, because it's a very slow leak on this one. It doesn't lose coolant very quickly, so I'm pretty sure it's only here. Unfortunately, it's the radiator core, which is it is fixable, but not by me. You could solder it, I think, but I can't. You could also put some additive in the system, some anti-leak sealant stuff you can put in that will find the hole and then clog it. You could also just put in an egg, or some grounded coffee would also do the trick, but I wouldn't advise it, especially not, oh, I wouldn't advise it at all. But on an old car like this, the coolant system is most likely completely filled with rusty scales and stuff like that, and you don't want to clog it even further, because sometimes it's actually the reason why a car overheats, because the system is so clogged up. So I wouldn't advise that. I would get this fixed or change the entire radiator. So this is not a problem we are going to fix today, but we found it, And sometimes you just have to be a bit creative with the stuff you got, because I could go and buy the right kit for testing the coolant system, and I would actually like to do that at some point, because there are a lot of adapter types in those kits that is nice to have, but I don't have it. And very often you can get the same result by just using what you got. So yeah, this will be all for this video. See you in the next one. Yeah, the video was supposed to stop right there, but it's not going to, because I had to move the Volvo when moving the Benz. There's quite a lot of cars here at the moment and not a lot of room. But anyway, when you have a lot of cars, it's a very good idea to plan when you actually check up on your oil and your coolant and all that. Of course, you should do it when you are on a trip in the cars, but it's a good idea to actually do it in some kind of planned manner, especially when you have a lot of cars, because I can't remember how many times I actually had to try to fix a problem on a mate's car or a family car or something like that, and it turns out to be self-inflicted. I do believe that maybe at least 50% of car-related breakdowns are due to errors from the driver or the owner. It's just a guess, and I think it actually is even more than that. So it's a good idea to check those things. So I just checked the Volvo, and it turned out that the Volvo was actually a bit low. Not alarmingly low, but low. A car like this got a temperature gauge. Not all cars got one of those. The Citroën C1, for instance, does not have a temperature gauge. I do expect it to actually light some light if it gets too hot, but there's no gauge, because if you have a gauge, you will notice it begin to go a bit higher than normal when it's low on coolant, but you shouldn't even get to that point, actually. Anyway, let's do the same to this car as we did to the Benz and see if we can find the coolant leak and yeah, fix it. So the engine layout on the Volvo is pretty much the same as the Mercedes, but the coolant system is a bit different. This one does not have the cap on the radiator itself. It got an expansion tank, which is a bit more modern. What I can do with that, I can remove this. It is right now on the minimum, and I know it's normally on maximum. So it has lost some fluid. It's not a lot, but a little bit. The engine could be eating it. That would be head gasket related or something else. But I don't think that's the case. I rigged up this, a cap that fits with a little nozzle and a piece of plastic hose. Let's put it on and put the pressure gauge on. And let's put some pressure on it. Oops, that's the wrong way. And again, don't go crazy with the pressure, because right now there's no fail-safe on the system other than the hoses itself. So don't go crazy. I will go to this point. I just try to listen for a leak. I cannot hear anything. So therefore, it's just a matter of going around and checking. Very often the leak would be at the water pump down there on many cars. They begin to leak when they are worn out. This one is new, and I cannot see any leaks down there. Another thing is the radiator itself, of course, as the other car. I cannot see any leaks from there. But I think I'm lucky, because I just spotted something. And once again, it seems to be a self-inflicted error. And it just proves once again, at least in my world, that could be down to me, actually. But it's very often a human error. that's the fault that could lead to a breakdown of overheating. But take a look at this. Water is, it's hard to see with the light, but water is seeping out from right there and there, extremely slowly. This hose, some of you might remember, I changed this hose a while back, so I haven't got it seated proper or haven't tightened it up proper. It could be down to not cleaning this area. I changed it on the fly, pulling the old one on and putting the new one on, so I didn't lose that much coolant, so that could be the case. I'm going to loosen it, wiggle it a bit and tighten it up and check it. So there we go. I've cleaned it up, loosened this one up and wiggled it for a bit and tightened it up again, cleaned it off and put it under pressure, and there is no leak anymore. So this is going to be all for this video. This was just a short video showing you how I go about finding leaks in the coolant system with the stuff that I had lying around. There's a lot of ways to do this, but this was just my way. So in the future we'll most likely make a video about changing the radiator on the Benz out there. This one is ready to go again. Let's see when it breaks down next time, but yeah, see you on the next one.